You're listening to the DolphinsTalk.com podcast network.
You're listening to DolphinsTalk.com Daily, the most listened to daily Miami Dolphins podcast on the internet. Come on, Dolphins fans. Time to fins up.
Miami's got the Dolphins, the greatest football team. We take the ball from goal to goal like no one's ever seen.
Good morning, Miami Dolphins fans, and how are you today? And thank you for listening to the DolphinsTalk.com podcast. I am your host, Tom Ernesty. It has been a very long offseason for years truly. I have missed doing this on a weekly basis, bringing you my thoughts and opinions on the Miami Dolphins. Before we get into today's show, first, a big shout out to everyone listening over at finheaven.com, the largest Miami Dolphins message board on the internet. Again, that's finheaven.com. If you're not a part of it, go join them. In addition, I'd like to give another shout out to everyone listening over at the Facebook group, I Am a Miami Dolphins Fan, run by the great Carlos Hernandez. If you're not a part of that group, please go on to Facebook, search him out, answer a few questions, and you will be in that Facebook group. Before I get into the show, I also have to mention that another great show on our podcast network is back. Officially for a brand new season on Thursday, the Same Old Dolphins Show featuring Aaron the Brain and Josh Katzker. They again return on Thursday night with a brand new season and new episode of the Same Old Dolphins Show. So make sure you are tuned in and enjoy that wonderful show those brothers from the exact same mother bring to you each and every week here on the DolphinsTalk.com podcast network. So for me personally, I'm going to spend a minute just to talk about it because obviously you guys haven't heard my voice over really since January. I did a couple sporadic shows with Mike for free agency as well as the draft. But outside of that, I haven't been here. If you don't know, and the reason why I haven't been here is because I welcomed a beautiful baby boy to my family 6 months ago, actually, back at the end of January. My son Luca has graced us with his presence. Yes, he already has Dolphins gear. Yes, I'm already poisoning his little mind with Miami Dolphins talk as we are gearing up for football season. But it's essentially what it boils down to between work and obviously family life. I haven't been on the pod, but here I am back, and I'm very thankful to be back. I've missed all of you Dolphins fans. If you do follow me on social media, you know I have been active on there, but this is my first show back, so bear with me as we get rolling with it. First and foremost, we're going to talk about the roster moves that occurred over the last few days. We're going to talk about the joint practices that are going to be starting up here on Tuesday with the Atlanta Falcons coming to town and the week being capped off with the first preseason game from Hard Rock Stadium at 7:30 p.m. on Friday night. And also, we want to talk about the offensive line and some of the movement that is occurring there, and also want to touch on Pete Prisco's comments regarding Austin Jackson and why that's kind of an overreaction from him regarding the offensive line and a particular guy on the offensive line. So let's start with the roster moves themselves. The Miami Dolphins decided to waive quarterback James Blackman, and they announced they have signed cornerback Perry Nickerson. Nickerson, who has bounced around the league, most recently he was with looks like he was with the New York Jets in 2018. He was in Jacksonville in 2019, Green Bay in 2020, and Minnesota in 2021. He's played in 25 career games, including three starts. He has 23 total tackles, a pass defended, and five special teams stops. Originally entered the NFL as a sixth-round pick, 179th overall by the New York Jets in 2018 after playing at Tulane in college. Now the Dolphins, again, waived quarterback James Blackman. Blackman, if you don't remember, he was at Florida State for 4 years, and then he transferred to Arkansas State, where he had a pretty productive season. I mean, not all world by any means, but he has been waived. Now, part of my problem with the quarterback being waived is we're gearing up for our first preseason game, and I do not want to see QB1 on the field at all in the preseason. No, thank you. We know what's at stake this season with the Miami Dolphins, and the health of quarterback Tua Tagovailoa is essential for this season, as we saw what happened when he did not play in 2022. So you could have kept Blackman around for a couple preseason games, given reps obviously to Mike White and Skylar Thompson are going to be important, but they're also important to keep healthy. So, you know, bringing a guy like Blackman on, could have played him mostly in, you know, the end of the games, fourth quarters, second halves of other preseason games, just to give him some reps to see if he's even remotely worth a potential practice squad spot. As we know, the Dolphins are going to have three quarterbacks active every Sunday based on the new rules that were created. The other roster moves, the Dolphins signed defensive tackle Deshaun Hand and waived defensive tackle Anthony Montalvo. Hand has appeared in 31 career games with 11 starts, having played for Detroit 2018 to 2021, Tennessee Titans. Last season, he is entering his sixth year. Hand has 54 career tackles, 3 sacks, 2 passes defended, 3 forced fumbles, and a fumble recovery. He was originally a fourth-round pick by the Detroit Lions in 2018, and he played collegiately at Alabama, where he was on the same defensive line as Raekwon Davis. So there's familiarity there with a teammate in Raekwon Davis. Montalvo was an undrafted free agent in 2023. He played 5 seasons at UCF. He was a walk-on there, and unfortunately he is gone. So Dolphins wanted some veteran help on the defensive line behind starters Raekwon Davis and Christian Wilkins. So Deshaun Hand is on hand to hopefully provide that veteran depth. Now, I don't believe they're going to be done adding defensive linemen as we progress through the summer. Obviously, injuries may occur. I don't think Hand is the guy that they may have going forward. He's there right now. He's there to compete for a job. We'll see if he can perform and get that job. But I personally just don't think the Dolphins are done adding defensive line help. They lost, you know, John Jenkins in the offseason. They don't have that veteran guy, and, you know, Lord knows Raekwon Davis hasn't stayed healthy through the course of his career so far. So we need to have somebody there. But Deshaun Hand's there now, so we'll see how he performs, especially this week during the practices and in that first preseason game, because he is going to get a longer look than, say, a Christian Wilkins, who, again, a guy I don't want to see very much in the preseason. He doesn't need to show us anything. We know what the guy can bring to the table. I mentioned the joint practices starting up on Tuesday in the morning. Obviously, follow those main accounts. Travis Wingfield from the Miami Dolphins main account. He is tremendous at coverage throughout the season, but especially in the summer when folks like myself cannot be there for those practices or the joint practices. So, you know, you want to rely on the right people to follow. Travis obviously is one of the guys to follow, but, you know, there are other great members of the Dolphins media down there that cover the team. So be sure to be following those accounts, have those notifications turned on so you can keep up with what's going on, as I do. What are we looking for in these joint practices? Well, at the top, staying healthy is the biggest thing in these joint practices. We know with the joint practices with Tampa Bay, last year Trill Williams tore his ACL as he was having a phenomenal training camp to start, and then The ACL injury happened, and we lost him for the year. So staying healthy is going to be the most important thing. But what matchups am I going to be looking for, as well as you should? The one that really stood out to me is Cam Smith versus the Falcons wide receiving group. As you all probably know, Cam Smith has been having a very, very strong start to training camp. He is making play after play. He's breaking up a lot of passes. Quarterbacks are tending to try to stay away from him in the 11-11s. He is performing great. He is looking like the guy they drafted in the second round and a guy that can supplant Jalen Ramsey while he is out with injury. Because that battle for cornerback two next to Xavier Howard is definitely heating up. And surprisingly enough, the other name with Cam Smith that's having a very strong start to the summer is Noah Igbinoghene. Yes. You don't have to rewind it. I said it. Noah Igbinoghene is having a strong start to the summer. Now, we've heard this before, but clearly it's starting to transition on the field as he's been making plays. From what we've seen, yes, he's been burnt a few times as well, but that's what training camp is for, is to work on those mistakes. Obviously, Eli Apple, who was brought in, he's also making some strides, making plays. So the cornerback two battle should start to kind of work itself out. But for me, Cam Smith is the big name to watch as he goes against the wide receivers of the Atlanta Falcons, namely Drake London, former Dolphin Mack Hollins, Scotty Miller's lining up in the slot. They got Frank Darby, J.J. Arcega-Whiteside, Matthew Sexton, Kadarryl Hodge, Kalon Harris, Slade Bolden, Penny Hart. I mean, there's a lot of guys that you probably don't know who the hell they are, but these are, Drake London and Mack Hollins. Mack Hollins, based on what has been posted, he's been causing some hell in Atlanta's camps. He's been very aggressive, and he looks more polished than he was as a wide receiver when he was with the Dolphins. So that is a matchup you want to watch for. Cam Smith versus the Falcons wide receivers. We're going to see probably a lot of Cam Smith on Mack Hollins and Drake London. Obviously, he's going to cover some of the other guys through these drills, but that is the key matchup for me. Next is the defensive line. The Miami Dolphins defensive line versus the Falcons offensive line. The Falcons have a lot of youth up front. They have spent a lot of draft capital on starting offensive linemen. In 2019, they drafted Caleb McGarry at right tackle and Chris Lindstrom at right guard, both first-round players. Drew Dahlman right now is listed as the starting center. They drafted Matthew Bergeron this past draft in the second round. And obviously Jake Matthews, who is a first-round pick back all the way in 2014 at left tackle. This is a good start. This is a good test for the Dolphins' defensive line and defensive unit as a whole. But I'm very intrigued to see how Emmanuel Agba, who's coming off of injury from last year, how he's going to perform. I'd like to see a little bit from Raekwon Davis. I think if we could get a semblance of what that guy was supposed to be drafted in the second round of 2020, we could be in for a good season with Raekwon. Now, the other guys that I really want to see something from is not just the starters. I want to see something from a guy like a Brandon Peely. I want to see something from a guy like Randy Charlton. These are the guys that could fill in those depth roles, right? Jalen Twyman, Josiah Bronson. There is opportunity for these young kids possibly to get a roster spot, if not find their way on the practice squad, but they have to show that they can perform against other teams. You know, we've been hearing great things about Brandon Peely. Let's see if he can do it against an opposing team. Let's see if he can do it against the Falcons offensive line, who I think is not terrible by any stretch. So this is a good test for the defensive line. I'd like to see how Channing Tindall does. How's Cameron Good going to perform? We know what we have with Chubb, Phillips. David Long Jr. has had a good summer. Jerome Baker is having a good summer. Malik Reed, who came over from the Denver system with Vic Fangio. How are these guys going to perform? I want to see pressure on Desmond Ridder. I want to see them get after Taylor Heinicke. Let's see how this defense responds to not going against Tua and the Dolphins offense. Another matchup to watch for me, and I hope you too, is how the Dolphins defense handles a guy like Bijan Robinson. That kid is going to be a very, very good football player. And this is, again, a really good test to start the week of practice with the Falcons leading up to the preseason game. I don't know how much we're going to actually see Bijan Robinson in the first preseason game, but the Dolphins are going to get a long look at him for the next 3 days, Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday. So we'll see how it all plays out and how this defense is going to perform against a guy like Bijan Robinson in these practices. Last but not least, which will also lead me into the final topic of today's show, is the matchup of the Dolphins' offensive line versus the Atlanta Falcons' front seven. So we saw from the scrimmage that occurred on Saturday, the Dolphins' offensive line got their asses kicked. And I'm putting that as nicely as possible. This offensive line is not 100% gelled. Obviously, Terron Armstead just getting going. I don't think we'll see very much of him at all this week. He's going to take reps, but I don't think we're going to see him do a lot, as he doesn't need to. But what's going on with the Dolphins' offensive line? How that's going to shake out? Who's going to be starting at left guard? We'll get some answers. We'll start getting some answers. Before I get into the final topic of talking of the Dolphins' offensive line and the movement on that offensive line, we are going to talk about our sponsor, Caldera Lab. You know you're going to brush your teeth today, and incorporating skincare steps before it guarantees to not mess up your routine, leaving your breath fresh and your face refreshed. Caldera Lab creates high-performance men's skincare products, and the regimen leads off their product lineup, a twice-a-day routine to transform your skin. Caldera Lab knows the skincare world is heavily female-driven and has long been the wild, wild west for men. That's why they are making the solution simple. The regimen includes three products: the Clean Slate, the Base Layer, and the Good. The Clean Slate starts your and ends your day. This face wash leaves all skin types refreshed. The Base Layer is your daily moisturizer to hydrate your skin and jumpstart your day full of confidence. And the Good is your go-to multifunctional serum at night that helps your skin look tighter and smoother, as well as helps reduce the visibility of wrinkles and fine lines. Every drop of this serum is packed with 3.4 million antioxidant units protecting your skin. And the Caldera Lab Icon Eye Serum, it addresses the three most common skin concerns around the eye: the fine lines, the dark circles, and the puffiness. Listen, guys, I've tried this stuff. It really is refreshing. It makes your face very smooth. It gives you a little shine to your face. And if you do it consistently, it does do the job. It removes those lines. It removes those removes the dark circles and the puffiness around those eyes. It tightens up that skin, so some of those maybe wrinkles that you may have, they go away. So be sure to go to CalderaLab.com. That is, again, CalderaLab.com. Use the promo code DolphinsTalk, and you get 20% off your order. Again, 20% off at calderalab.com using the code DolphinsTalk and make unforgettable first impressions that lead to the charming words, "You look younger." Let's finish off the show with talking offensive line and some movement on that offensive line. Now, they cannot report who lines up where, what, because it's against rules. As Mike said on the show last week, you don't have to be a rocket science to figure out who is lining up where. So, from my opinion, okay, because I'm not reporting anything, I'm just going to give my opinion. The Dolphins are going to line up Teron Armstead at left tackle. They're going to have Connor Williams at center. We know Robert Hunt's going to be at right guard, and we know Austin Jackson's going to be at right tackle. Left guard, as reported, has been a wide-open competition. So my opinion is Isaiah Wynn is going to end up winning that job. Because per Omar Kelly and some of the other beat reporters that are there, is Christian Wilkins is, quote-unquote, eating Liam Eichenberg up. They are taking his lunch money, is what I've been told. That's not good. That's not good. But there's another guy that has been holding his own against Christian Wilkins and Raekwon Davis. His name is Isaiah Wynn. So don't be stunned when it comes down to it and the offensive line movement occurs that there might be a new starting left guard for the Miami Dolphins. Albeit there's still concern on the right side with Austin Jackson. So Pete Prisco from CBS Sports was in Miami, and he was watching the Dolphins practices over the weekend. And one of the things that he said that stood out was Austin Jackson was kind of like, what do you say, like a spin table or something like that, as Jalen Phillips and Bradley Chubb were just working around him. And he did not look good. He was also put on his butt on a bull rush, et cetera, et cetera. Now, we know that this is the case with Austin Jackson. He has struggled throughout his career to perform at a high level. But I am here to tell you, it's just the second week of training camp. And Jalen Phillips is a freaking monster. By the way, he's going to have double-digit sacks this year. Just throwing it out there now. But the fact that Austin Jackson is able to compete against the likes of Bradley Chubb, an Emmanuel Agba, a Jalen Phillips, an Andrew Van Ginkel, he gets opportunities to go against some of the better players in the NFL in Phillips and Chubb. Good depth guys behind them. Van Ginkel's no slouch. The guy can get sacks. I'm here to say pump the brakes on saying the season will be an absolute disaster. We know it's going to be a disaster if Austin Jackson's terrible. We know that. But for God's sakes, it's August 7th. It's going to be August 8th as I record this. Let the man practice. Guess what? Tyreek Hill has dropped a ton of passes so far this summer. Does that mean he's going to be terrible? No. You're working the kinks out. Austin Jackson busted his butt. He's in shape. They're coaching him up. Let's see how he does when it matters. I could care less that he's getting put on his ass by an elite pass rusher like Jalen Phillips. Jalen Phillips puts a lot of good tackles on their ass. He beats a lot of good tackles in regular season games. I'm not saying Austin Jackson's going to be a all-pro right tackle this year. But I'm also not saying he's going to be the absolute worst thing. Now, if he gets hurt again, now my concerns get a little bit more rich. Behind him is Garen Christian, Cedric. Oh, yeah, I ain't going to pronounce that name. I got to still work on that stuff. And Keon Smith. Agbuhay. Yeah, we're going to go with that. See, I got to have my I don't have my cheat sheet in front of me on how to pronounce these guys' names. So, and long-time listeners know I'm not good at this stuff. But I'd be a little nervous as Austin Jackson does get hurt, because behind him is not any better. So have patience with Austin Jackson. Don't worry about him getting put on his butt by a guy like Jalen Phillips and Bradley Chubb, because they do that weekly against opposing teams. This is a big week of practice against another team. Let's see how he does this week. Let's see how he does most likely in the preseason game that he's going to be playing in on Friday night. Let's see how that all plays out before we start panicking. I'll start panicking when we get towards the end of the summer and if it's still a consistent thing, if he doesn't hold up well in the preseason games, if he gets hurt. I'll start panicking then. But the main thing is that we're going to have a new left guard. I didn't want to believe it. I thought he was here to be a backup tackle, which still can be the case if something happens on the right side or the left side with Teron Armstead. We know that he misses games. But I think we may see a new starting left guard. So be on the lookout for that. That will do it for my first show back. I want to thank everybody for listening. Be sure to go to DolphinsTalk.com every single day for all the latest Miami Dolphins news and information. If you're on Twitter, or X is what it's called now, you could follow me on there at DolphinsTalkTom. You can follow the main account on Twitter at DolphinsTalk. And be ready. Have that alert bell on wherever you listen to your podcast, so when we go with a new show, you are alerted and that show drops. If you are not a subscriber on our YouTube channel, be sure to go to Dolphins Talk on YouTube and smash that like button and subscribe to the channel. So when we go live with live shows, you'll be alerted of that as well. Thank you all for listening. Thank you for welcoming me back to the fold. I'm excited to get back into Dolphins football this year. And again, as another reminder, Thursday night, same old Dolphin show returns with Aaron the Brain and Josh Katzker here at DolphinsTalk.com podcast network. Be sure to check it out. Make sure you go to the YouTube channel so when they go live, you can join in on the show. Thank you all again. I appreciate each and every one of you. Fins up. Let's go.
Thank you for listening to the DolphinsTalk.com podcast. Be sure to visit DolphinsTalk.com every day for all of your latest Miami Dolphins news.